Ah, look at that. There we go, guys. Running super smooth on Windows 11. No issues whatsoever. So let's install Generals here on this clean Windows 11 installation. I'm going to be using the ISO files, but you can use the CDs. That's perfectly fine. The process is exactly the same. This also is going to work for all languages. So if you have the French game CDs or the German game CDs or whatever, it'll all work the exact same way. So just follow along. And at the end, I'm going to give you a link to a video showing you how you can still play online. Because yes, people still play online. There's loads of games, loads of players. So you should definitely check that out. But yes, let's jump right into it. Let's go install the game. So I have my ISO files here in the downloads folder. And guys, if you haven't already, I highly recommend you make a backup file of your CDs. You can do that by making an ISO file. Just Google around and then keep that in like Google Drive or something so you can download it when you need it. So these are mine from my actual original CDs. So on Windows 11, just right mouse click it and then do mount. Then scroll down and right mouse click on setup and do run as administrator. So here, just enter your serial as it's shown on the back of your CD box. Now the thing is, some deluxe edition boxes actually have invalid serial numbers for the installer, so you can't actually put them in here. So during the installation process, I actually have to put in a different serial number, which then I can change back later on after the installation is complete. It's a little stupid, but don't worry, just follow along. If you have a normal good serial number, just enter it here and skip to the point in the video that's shown on screen right now. So in order to get a serial for installing the game, just go to duckduckgo.com and type in serials WS. And I think it's this one. I don't know, it keeps changing URL, but something serials, something WS. And you'll basically get to a site that looks like this. You can just type in generals and then scroll down and find one that has a relatively high percentage. Just click it and you'll see the serial number and you can use it to actually install the bloody game. Okay, and basically you could just keep clicking next, 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 next. It's all good, it's all fine, don't have to worry about anything. And just wait until it finishes at around 37%. It's gonna stop then, it's gonna ask you to insert the second disc. So at that point, make sure you eject your current disc by right mouse clicking on it and hitting eject. And then just mount the second disc. Again, if you're using the CDs, just follow along. It's perfectly fine. It's the exact same process. And there we go, it has installed. So just click register later. And no, we don't want to run it because it's going to crash anyway. Perfectly fine. Just click no. And again, right mouse click, do eject. And now we're going to repeat the exact same process for Generals 0 Hour. It's literally the exact same. So scroll to the bottom, right mouse click setup, do run as administrator. And go next, 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 next. Now it'll freeze at around 45%. And again, just right mouse click, do eject, and mount the second CD. And there we go. Just hit register later again, and hit finish. Okay, now we can eject this again. It's always nice and recommended just to make sure you don't have any extra stuff running there. Okay, so now the game is technically installed. It'll be version 1.0 that is filled and riddled with bugs that is probably not gonna work on Windows 11. But there is a nice little thing called a Genpatcher. So Genpatcher is a program that will actually fix up the game and get it running on Windows 11. It will also install all required patches and you can install extra stuff with it like maps and things like that. For Genpatcher, it is recommended, but not required, to actually switch off the real-time threat protection on Windows. The reason for it is because Windows threat protection can start interfering with Genpatcher as it's trying to fix the game, so generally it's best to disable it, so I highly recommend you do that. So in order to do that, just hit the Windows key on your keyboard, type in security, and click on Windows Security. And go to Virus and Threat Protection, go to Manage Settings over here, and just switch off real-time protection. Hit yes, and that's it. It'll be fine. Now go to leggy.cc/genpatcher and click on the first link you see. Let it download and then extract it to your desktop. Then just run it. It will ask if it can run as administrator. Just hit yes and let it start up. It'll take a while to start up for the very first time. Also, if you were unsure about Genpatcher or you just want some more information about it, there's actually a tutorial video linked below giving you all the information you need. So here we go. The only thing we have to do is click on Apply Fixes. And basically, it'll download all the required files right now to make sure your game's gonna run fine on Windows 11. Over here, when the patch opens up, just click OK. And okay again. And okay again. And there we go. Now you get a nice message saying, congratulations, your game is now fixed. And it's telling you, do you want to get Gentool? Just click yes. If you know what Gentool is, you'll want to click yes. If you don't know what Gentool is, you also want to click yes. So just click yes. And there we go. Now, the next step is going to be to change back the serial number to the actual serial number from before. So if you want to do that, just click edit serial number. And you'll see that your serial numbers are now being shown. You can just change them all to whatever you want. And it's perfectly fine. So I'm just going to do that for a sec. And when you're done, just hit apply. And there we go. All fixed and sorted. So at this stage, your game is technically ready. You can play it, all good, all fine. But I like to install some extra stuff too. So I like to go to additional content and get the fancy control bar. Because look how fancy, man. Look how fancy. It's so nice. So I like to get this. So just hit download and install. And it'll download and install it for you. Nice and convenient. Then I also like to get the hotkeys from LA Keys. This one, I like it a lot. And then I like to go to Gentool and switch on borderless full screen window mode. And that's it. Now I have the game the way I like it. And of course, last but not least, gonna get the maps. Of course you're gonna get the maps. How can you not get the maps, guys? Get the maps. Okay, and it looks like we're ready with a gen patcher over here. So we could just close this. And now you'll see that there are two shortcuts on your desktop. I've enabled borderless full screen window, so I like to play window mode. So at this stage, all you're gonna do is just double click it. And whoa, look at that! It's actually running. Got a little intro video here. We can skip. And let's see. Ah, look at that. There we go, guys. Running super smooth on Windows 11. No issues whatsoever. Anyway, let's check out a quick skirmish game just to make sure everything's okay. Whoa, look at that. Super smooth. All fine. No issues. All working great, with the nice new hotkeys, the nice new control bar. Anyway, I'm gonna quit out here. Now let's close the game. And you will see a little Gentool updater window that shows up. Just let it do its thing, just give it a moment. It's gonna install some more maps and some other updates and things like that. And there we go, when it says press any key to continue, you can press any key to continue and it should close off the window. And that's it! Now you have a full functioning, very happy, very stable Command & Conquer Generals installed on Windows 11 and you are ready to go play online. So for doing that, you gotta follow one of these videos. Check them out, guys. I recommend going for the Game Ranger one. And yeah, hopefully I will see you guys online on the battlefield. And that's gonna wrap up this video here. If it helped you out, if the game's working for you, then make sure to give a like. It's always appreciated. And yeah, that's gonna be it, guys. Goodbye and see ya.